Mr. Gurdeep Singh is Chairman and Managing Director of NTPC, as you all know, has been now in this position for almost 2 years, and has come to NTPC with a mix of experience, both public and private, and both Indian and multinational. So very unique experience. He, for example, has worked with multinational companies like PowerGen, CLP. He's also worked with Indian companies like IDFC and AES. And that was before he joined Gujarat State Electricity Corporation and Managing Director. And now, of course, he's spearheading the country's leading power producer, NTPC. And I would now request him to deliver his opening remarks. Mr. Singh, please. And I'm very grateful that despite his very busy schedule and having to go to a meeting, he agreed to come here for a short time. Thank you very much, Mr. Singh, for that.
Yeah, good morning, Mr. Barara, dear participants. I think first of all, let me apologize that I had to rush through and I could not really resist more. And I had to accept that whatever time then it suits, so that's the reason it's at 9:30 rather than the usual time. I think the today's topic, we'll try to then just be as focused as we can on the coal-based generation. As we all know that in the last few years, means 2 to 3 years at least, this is power situation from the supply side is very comfortable. And that is a very, very kind of rare achievement, which we could really achieve after a very, very long time. Because earlier than that, whenever we were discussing, this was a shortage situation from the supply side. So that's a very happy situation. There are many people who used, even today there are some people who are saying that we are quite surplus. There were some people then about 6 months back, mostly then people were saying that there is a excess supply and low demand. So the good news is that demand is increasing at a very healthy pace. And we have registered in the last quarter more than 10% increase. Primarily it has come from coal-based generation. This month also, the what increase we are registering is even more than the quarter, so it's around 11%. And again, as I just mentioned, this is mainly coming from the coal generation. So we can't just wish away that the coal generation is the thing of past and we have to only and only look for the renewables. Having said that, going forward, we will have to, there is no other option. And as rightfully the government's agenda of going forward for 175 gigawatt and probably even more, the Honorable Minister has been on record to say that we will surpass that and there is no reason that we should not be able to do that. So maybe that it's not only 175, maybe even 200 plus gigawatt, which is going to be by 2022. That's what the target is towards the renewable. And why I'm just mentioning this in the beginning is there is a scope for everything. Before the storage really have the breakthrough in the affordability, we have no other option but to rely on coal. Because the gas power plants mostly will remain underutilized because of the increase in the imported LNG prices. And this is kind of unaffordable as of now, and whatever is the domestic gas we are able to really utilize. There is some more gas which is coming from the ONGC side. Let us see that how much we will be able to get. So that is another one. But let us come back to the coal side. I think when it is coming to the coal-based generation, there are many challenges. And most of us who have been in the sector would have been just noticing this. There are very old plants. There are plants which are brand new. There are plants which are supercritical. There are plants which are pithead. Fortunately, even the transmission corporation has also added a lot of capacity. So there is the congestion, you know, what the transporting the power from one region to the other has eased out. So there is no reason that we should be able to utilize, number one, that the lowest cost, what we can achieve from the coal-based generation. And going forward, as the environment is becoming, environment compliance become more and more stringent, and this is also the requirement of the day. One is that we will be adding more and more renewable so that we can really increase the percentage of the generation. But at the same time, what we should be looking at is that how we can make this coal-based generation as clean as possible. So supercritical anyway because of its efficiency, the per unit generation, the emission level is much low. But at the same time, we will have to go towards implementation of the new environment norms, which there is a debate on that, whether it is how urgent it was or not. But I think now I'm not getting into that because there is a direction from the MOEF. So I'm just restricting myself on that guidelines. One can have their own opinion. But like we have for NCR plants, we have only extension up to December 19, whereas for some other plants, most of the other plants is going up to December 22. So there is a lot of work which has to be done in this. Merit order, as we all know, is a part of the coal cost or the variable cost, what we are saying. If tomorrow the environment norms, it's already kicked in. So once, even if the plant is at the pit head and it is inefficient and it is not complying with the environment norms, then probably it will find very difficult. Whereas we are still supplying around 80% of the power from coal-based generation and the challenges are many. So in this context, we will have to make sure that we start taking care of the efficiency and environment side as much as possible. And going forward, I think we are the probably one of the company in the world which is adding maximum as of now, around 20 gigawatt under construction. We believe that India will still need some more capacity on coal. How much? That is just something which I think CEA and the Ministry of Power is working together. There is a lot of emphasis from the ministry side. I'm part of that, some of the discussions that how to really make the power generation as efficient as possible. So we can get into many things, but again, the topic is only and only about the coal-based generation. I think another topic probably is very relevant is that the coal supply, probably last year there has been from the Coal India that complaints was coming that the coal plants are not lifting the coal. The situation is changing, and many of the plants are really it's able to ramp up their generation, and that's the reason the coal stock level is not that high that what it used to be, and some of the plants are mostly and then some of the plants are relying on something at very low stock level. This type of conference, I believe that will be for the further discussion and deliberation and what we should be going rather than seeing that who is what is there. So with this, some of the preliminary comments, I think I will close here.